Are Jason Morgan's test results back yet? Well, I don't have to tell you how important it is, so please call me as soon as they're back. Thank you. Well, what is going on here? There are a lot of Hershey's Kisses in a row. What is this?
It's a trail, Mommy.
A trail to what?
To your Valentine's Day present.
Now, what could this trail possibly lead to?
Well, it's definitely a special order. One of a kind. Didn't know if I was going to get here in time, but it's your lucky day.
Do I also get to eat all the chocolates on the way?
I don't know about that. Since she gets the gift, I say we get the candies. What do you think? You want to share?
Yeah.
Oh, that's good. Okay. That's exactly what I taught you. Okay, well, come on. Come with me along the trail. Do-do-do. Here, one for you. One for Mommy.
Took a little wizardry to pull this off. Formidable obstacles had to be overcome.
Really? What kind of obstacles?
Hmm? Mommy, open the door.
Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. Mom! I can't believe you're actually here.
Oh my gosh, well, you have your husband to thank for that. You know, this young man was awfully determined to track me down. He rankled bureaucrats on about three continents.
Yeah, one of these days you're gonna have to explain to us why everybody you work with denies you exist.
Yeah, one of these days. Wow.
Look at you. Oh my God. You're so big.
I'm so pretty. Your mom sends me pictures every now and again. But it's not as good as the real thing.
I love you, Grandma. Happy Valentine's Day.
Oh, Emma. Happy Valentine's Day. You could call me Anna. If you want.
Okay, Gal Anna.
Oh, yeah.
Do whatever.
And this is for you.
It's a kite.
Yes, wow. That it is. It is a very special kite, however. It has come all the way from Kuala Lumpur, where every year there is this amazing kite festival. I mean, kite flyers from all over the world come to Malaysia to fill the sky with kites. As far as the eye can see, there's unicorns and dragons and elephants and whatever you can imagine.
Thank you, Gamma Anna.
Oh, you're so welcome.
You want to take that to your room and go tell Butterscotch all about it?
I want to tell Butterscotch all about you, Gamma Anna.
Aww. Oh, she's sticking with that name.
She is.
Gosh, she's so cool. She's exceptional. Mm. Well, of course she is, given her parents. My goodness. It just seems like yesterday that you were pregnant. And we were at that courtroom, you know, where you two were duking it out about custody. Never in my life have I met two people more stubborn about professing their love for each other. Ridiculous. I was actually really glad that I was there to see your declaration. Because then, you know, I knew how much my daughter was loved.
I'm glad you were there, too. We both are.
I should have been here months ago to be with you.
How much did Patrick tell you?
I told her that your HIV status was a little unstable and that you wanted to handle it all on your own.
Mom, I'm really sorry to worry you, but I'm fine now.
Yeah.
I promise.
But I could have been here, you know, with you, to support you and just hold you. I'll give you hell because you keep the people you love in the dark.
I know I was wrong. It's just that I jumped to the worst case scenario, you know, and I didn't want everyone else to have to deal with it as well, so I know that was the wrong thing to do, and I'm really sorry.
Well, it's okay. I mean, I've been known to keep a few secrets when I thought there was good reason, so I can't really criticize. I'm just so happy you're okay now.
Me too.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Well, as much as I would have loved for you to be here and support her, I'm glad you're here now.
Oh, good. I am too.
All my girls under one roof. Oh.
Come here. I haven't been called a girl in a long time.
Excuse me. This is Robin Scorpio-Drake. Thank you. Jason's test results are in. I mean, I'm just dealing with cerebral edema, and we have to look at another option because surgery is just not going to work this time.
Oh, wow. I'm so sorry to hear that. Sounds like you guys have your hands full as usual.
We do, and we have to go deal with this right now. I'm so sorry. I know you just got here.
No. That's okay. I'll get some quality time with Emma, you know? You guys go. Emma and I will be just fine. Emma?
Are you sure, Mom? I mean, I could just take her to daycare.
No, it's fine. It's fine. So, listen. Your mom and dad have to go out. They have to go to the hospital to take care of a very sick man. But I was thinking, maybe you and I could spend the day together. Perhaps have a little girl chat?
What do you say?
Yeah? Okay, good.
Yay, that means yes.
Okay, I will call and check in, make sure everything's okay. And you be good for Grandma Anna. Anna.
Mom.
Okay?
Okay.
All right, well, I mean, you'll be here when I get back,
oh,
right?
Yes, I will. I've taken a temporary leave, so there'll be plenty of time to catch up.
Okay, good, because I just want to hang out with...
Yeah, no, we will. You know, I am going to take full advantage of this long overdue family leave. So, go. Be brilliant.
Love you.
Bye.
Love you. Okay. Let's go fly a kite. Come on.
I really can't thank you enough for getting my mom to visit. That is the best Valentine's Day present ever.
Really? Well, I'm not really sure how to take that, since, generally speaking, inviting one's mother-in-law to visit isn't the most romantic.
I have all the romance I need sitting right in front of me.
Feelings mutual.
So, I'm curious, did you tell my mom anything about Lisa?
I mentioned that you went through an HIV scare, but not to worry that your levels were stable. I didn't mention anything about Lisa. I figured that's better for a face-to-face conversation.
Good. Well, as far as I'm concerned, my mother never has to know about it. I mean, I would rather enjoy her visit than try and gauge her reaction to something horrible.
Well, that'll probably save me a drop kick through a window. Not that I don't deserve it.
Okay, you want to give me a Valentine's Day present? Let's not talk about that anymore. Let's just focus on our future together and how lucky we are to be healthy, right?
Speaking of healthy, do you want me to tell Jason about the test results?
No, I think he needs to hear it from both of us.
No.
Yes.
No,
there's no other...
Excuse me. We have your latest test results back from the lab.
Please tell me you know what you're dealing with. We know how to fix this.
Well, I think this is just the thing for a grandma-granddaughter chat, don't you?
Yes, just the thing.
Just the thing. You know, you definitely have a look of your daddy around your eyes. I'm kind of mischievous, devilish. And then you've got your mommy smile, because I see you've got dimples right here. And then, unfortunately, maybe a little bit of Grandpa Robert right there. Oh! Ooh, you're a little trickster! I think you get that from me. Which probably means that you're a little bit ticklish. Oh, this is fun, isn't it?
Mommy got sick.
I know. I know she did. But she's all better now. And she's at the hospital. And she's working on her very good friend to help make him better, too. See, your mommy is a miracle worker. Do you know that?
Can we pray for her friend?
Oh, sweetie. I think that would be just wonderful. Will you help me? Yeah? Show me what to do?
The condition.
situation is complicated because the swelling is in a place that's very difficult to get to without causing any permanent damage.
If the swelling continues to escalate the way it is, it'll further compress area of your brain responsible for motor skills, your blood pressure, your breathing.
Wait a minute. It sounds like you're giving him a death sentence.
No, I'm already working on a drug therapy that will help stabilize his cerebral tissues.
Okay, well, if I'm on a clock and my time is limited, I want to be spending it with you, not lying in a hospital bed waiting to die.
Jason, I understand that, but the truth is I need you here. We have to keep monitoring you, so can you please just stay here and give me the chance to help you? It's too soon to jump.
What does that mean?
Jason helped me through some hard times, and I'm trying to return the favor.
Okay, well, Jason, please give Robin the time she needs to figure out what's going on. Please, let her help.
Okay, I'll stay for now.
Okay, thank you. We're doing everything we can for him.
For who?
For Jason. Sorry, I assume that's why you were here. We had to admit him again.
Why? What happened?
He collapsed and he has some swelling on the brain.
Well, what are you doing to fix him?
I'm working on a drug protocol right now to reduce the swelling.
Okay, so he's gonna be okay, right?
I don't know. It's a complicated process and Jason doesn't have much time.
Surprised to see me?
Relieved. I know this is the last place in the world you want to be.
Can I ask you something?
Of course.
If this cure that Robin's working on doesn't work, you need to tell me because I need to know what I'm facing.
If Robin's exhausted every possibility, I promise I'll tell you. But up until then, we all need to do everything to try and beat this.
Okay, what do you need me to do besides sit here and be tested?
Try and relax. And I know that sounds crazy, but don't aggravate your condition. Any upsurge in adrenaline or dopamine will only make your condition worse.
I'm lost.
Excitement, anxiety, but especially the anger that you have towards Franco, I believe that's the trigger that's killing you.